Hi, I'm Coach Jeremiah Boswell, and welcome again to another Junior NBA at Home workout. Today we're joined by WNBA star Lexie Brown.
Heads up play.
Lexi, how are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Doing great. Thanks for joining us. So, a little background for everybody out there. Lexi played her high school basketball at North Gwinnett in Georgia, where I also played high school basketball. She then went on to Maryland and then Duke. In 2018, she was the ninth pick in the WNBA draft and is now a guard for the Minnesota Lynx. So, pretty exciting stuff. You've had a great journey, and we look forward to learning from you.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited.
Great, great. So everybody at home, notice we just have a basketball here. Each of us have a little bit of space. We have some water, so we encourage you to do the same. Join us and participate and learn from this WNBA star. So while you're doing that, while you're getting ready, Lexi, you know we've launched the Her Time to Play initiative, which is really about making sure girls have just a great, positive, fun experience with basketball. And you are such a wonderful role model for young ladies across the world. So just any message for young girls out there who, you know, maybe learn the game for the first time or may aspire to be like you in the WNBA?
The only thing I can say for young girls, high school, middle school, any age really, is just always be the hardest worker in the room. And you know, some things just take time. I wasn't always the best player on my team. I wasn't the second or third best player on some of my teams when I started, but I always made sure I was the hardest worker. I stayed in really good shape, and I just, you know, stayed my course. I knew what my goals were, and, you know, I locked into those. You can't look to what other people are doing around you if they don't have the same goals as you. So really, you just have to believe in yourself and push yourself as much as you can, and you can achieve anything.
I love it. Such a great message. So with that, I think we're all ready to get warmed up. So first and foremost, we have to make sure our body is ready to perform. So we're going to start without the basketball. And the first drill we're going to do, Lexi, is going to be a squeeze and explode. So what you're going to do is squeeze your knee up like a big knee hug. You'll put it back down. And then the next one, you'll explode it up nice and quick. We'll then change to the other leg. We'll squeeze it, and then we'll explode. And you'll kind of alternate legs, bouncing back and forth between squeeze and explode, right? So put it down and explode. Exactly, perfect. Great job. Squeeze it up, explode up. Good. And then with the squeeze, sometimes you can pull it across, sometimes be out. Depends on where you feel like you need that stretch. Really just trying to hit these hips and legs a little bit and start to get those explosive twitches going as well. Great. Good. Good work. Good work. Keep going. We'll go about 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Good job. All right. Next, we'll go 2 quick and out. So we're going to go lateral here. We're in a good stance. And we're just going to get our right foot going out 2 times nice and quick. And then we push out nice and big, almost like a lunge, and come back. So it's quick, quick, out. Quick, quick, out. All right. So we'll go 8 each leg, Lexi. So quick, quick, out. Yeah, perfect. Great job. Quick, quick, out. Good. There's 2. We're going to do 8 each way. That's perfect. So we're getting those fast twitch muscles going in the foot with those quick ones. Getting that hip, hamstrings, glutes, everything going with that lateral lunge. That's perfect. That's perfect. Great job. Good form. Way to sit back. Love it. Woo. I love it. All right. Now we got to do the same thing on the other leg. Yes. Yes. Perfect. I'm going to do it with you. 2. Good. Here we go. 1, 2. Out. Good job. Perfect.
I lost count.
I'll call it 6. I used to have a coach that would always say I had 1 if I lost count, but we'll say that's 7.
Right.
Good job. Good job. All right. Now we're going to get our upper body going a little bit too. So we're just going to go up. It's like we're going vertical on defense. Stretching up, going up on our toes, getting a good stretch here. And then we're going to swing down a little bit more explosively. So we're up, and then we swing down. So you can hold that up for a second and exhale as you come down. Perfect. Up on those toes, so we're getting those calf muscles going a little bit. Up, explode down. That's great. We're gonna get 8 of these. I lose count all the time, so no problem.
I lose count this time.
There you go. Good. Perfect. We're getting our body ready to perform. It's so important to prevent injuries. That's great. Is that 8?
Yep.
That was it. Good. Grab the ball. We'll keep going with some warm-ups with the ball. All right. We're going to start with the ball on our right side. We're going to go wrap, toss, and clap. So what we do here is we wrap it behind our back. When we get to the front, we toss, we clap 2 times, and then we go again. So boom, boom, wrap, boom, boom. Good. We're going to race to 10. All right?
We're going to race?
We're going to race. Me, you, and everybody else watching. All right? So we got to be nice and quick and quick claps. Ready? Oh, you already started. All right. All right, going to 10. Good. Now you got to count right.
That's 10.
Oh, you beat me. All right, so we're gonna do it again. We're going to go from the left hip and wrap the other way. But this time you have to count all 10, because if you don't hear me, I don't know if you're really counting to 10.
Okay, I got you.
All right, ready? Go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
You know what? I think I beat you, but I only clapped once on the last one, so I'm giving you the win again.
Thank you.
Good job. All right, now we're going to go wrap, wrap, and step back. Okay, so the ball's back on our right hip. We're going to wrap it once, wrap it twice, and now we're going to step across with our left foot like we're doing a step back. So we're going in and pushing out. So it's wrap, wrap, step back. Okay, and we can come back to the triple threat stance like we're ready to shoot too. Exactly. Okay, so we're going to do, let's just do 8 each way on these. Okay, so no race, 8 good reps, wrap, wrap, step back. Yep, come back to that triple threat stance. Exactly, knees bent, wrap, wrap, step back. Good. Good, really lean into that front leg, push back, balance the shoe. Perfect. Wrap, wrap, step back. Good, there we go. Good job. Wrap, wrap, step back. Perfect, good. Good, that was 8?
Yep.
Let's do 8 the other way. Perfect, perfect. So really lean into this. Try to pick up the pace a little bit now. Wrap a little quicker. Step a little more aggressively. Here we go. Perfect, good. You can step across your body on that step. There it is. Good, perfect. Step it across. Boom. Nice. Coming back to balance, ready to shoot. That's perfect. Great job. Great job, Lexie. Keep working, keep working. All 8. All 8. Good job. Good job.
All 8.
All right, you got it right.
2 more.
Wait. And last one here, last one.
8.
Great job. You feeling warm?
Yeah, a lot of breath.
Good job. So now we've got our blood flowing. We're feeling pretty good. I just want to see if maybe you can share, like, I start feeling good once my blood gets going and I'm active. You know, what does sports and basketball kind of do for you and your mental health?
Yeah, for me, sports has just always been an escape. I always call it my happy place. It's a place where, like, I can pretty much control everything that's going on. I can control my effort. I can control what workouts I'm doing that day. If I'm feeling a little down or lazy, I know I can just, you know, go get some shots up, or, you know, go on a jog outside or on the treadmill or something like that. So for my mental health, I know that people are always just like, why are you working out all the time? Why are you always in the gym? I mean, it makes my days better. So that's what, you know, sports and exercise does for me.
I love it. So true for me too. I always feel better when I'm got a ball in my hand. I'm moving around a little bit. So that's awesome. Thank you for sharing. Now we'll get into our ball handling. All right. So we're going to do this ball handling series called the split leg series. So the first one is really going to be working on our fingertips a little bit. So we'll just put a leg forward if you want to do your left leg or your right leg. So we're split leg here. We're going to do five between the legs first. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After my fifth one, now I do my fingertips from here to the starting point. And now I'm back here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fingertips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fingertips. Okay? We're going to go for 15 seconds on each leg. All right? Let's go. Here we go. Keep working. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Switch legs. That's all right. Switch legs. We're going to go split leg the other way. 5 between and fingertips. Ready. Let's go. Woo!
Two, one, relax.
You know what? I adjusted. I messed up severely. And so I wanted to make sure I got a good 15 seconds in for me. So I'm sorry for you, but it was my mess ups. My fault on that. So, extra work for your teammate, right? All right. Now this split leg, we're going to go pound, and we're working on control here. So we're still split leg. We're going to go pound and wrap the ball over and come back between our legs. So pound, over, between, pound, over, between. Okay, so it's more working on control here. Pound, exactly. 15 seconds, and I'm going to keep the clock right this time. All right?
Okay.
Ready? Go. I'm going to support you. Go. Here we go. Perfect. Good. Nice and quick. Good stance. Now we're working on control. We got our fingertips in. Control. That's perfect. Perfect. Great work. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Great job. All right. Now we're going to do the other leg. So we're just going to split stance again. Pound. Working on our control over between the legs. 15 seconds. Here we go, Lexie. Let's work. Good job. Good job. Keep going. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Good job. Good work. All right. The last part of the split leg series is going to be the game move, which is going to be our pullback. So now we're going to go pound. Now we're going to step forward this leg and pull back and come back here. Go between the legs, pound, pull back, between the legs, pound, pull back. Okay. I just hit the door on mine. My pullback was sloppy. Hopefully yours is better. All right. 15 seconds.
Pull back
between the legs, pound, and then do it again. Pound, pull back, perfect. Yeah, pound, pull back, perfect. There you go. Exactly. Here we go. Good job. Good. There we go. 5 seconds. That's perfect. 2, 1. Relax, good work. Yeah, I see you getting into it. Same thing on the other side.
Gotta get a little saucy.
Exactly, here we go. Perfect. Perfect, there we go. Exaggerate that step, perfect. Good work, good work, good work. There we go. Got 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Perfect. Great job. Great job. All right. Now, they can never say I didn't let you have a voice. You get to pick which drill we're going to do. Drill number one or drill number two?
You're not going to tell me what drill is which?
I'm not going to show you what drill. Yeah.
Okay, I picked drill
number two. Three scissors and cross. We're going to go for 30 seconds and we are racing.
Oh, no.
We're racing on this. So the way this one works is we go scissors, which is between the legs. One, two, three, and then we go cross, cross, and that's one rep. So one, two, three, cross, cross, one, one, two, three, cross, cross is two. All right? 30 seconds is a race. Positive vibes only.
I'm just using my shirt.
Awesome vibes only. Let's go, Lexie.
I love this.
30 seconds. I'm starting on you.
All
right. Good. There you go. Perfect. Keep working. 10 seconds. Good. 5 seconds. Two.
Oh,
one. Relax.
Woo. Woo. I got 11.
Did you count?
Yeah, 11.
Okay. You beat me. Because I failed to count. That was on me. It's hard to multitask sometimes. You beat me.
How you tell me to count when you forget to count?
I know. Sometimes as a coach, you have to just own it when you make mistakes, right?
Own your mistakes.
I can't have a double standard. You did a great job. This last one with ball handling here, hopefully it's going to get our heart rate to come back down for a second, all right? So it's a little bit more about rhythm, okay? So what we're going to do, we're just going to dribble, drop, and touch is what we're going to do, but we're going to take two dribbles. So the first one is up high. Second one is up high. But as the ball comes up, we're going to drop and touch the floor while the ball is in the air. So it's one, two, drop. One, two, drop. One, two, drop. So I'm trying to drop so that I can build my ability to move with the ball in the air. Exactly. Good. We'll do that 8 times each way, nice and light, just to build your rhythm. Right. On you. When you're ready, I'm just going to be your hype man. Great job. There you go. Perfect. Perfect. That's great. That's great. I love it. Great job.
7. 8.
Thank you for counting so loud.
I know, right?
No, leave the other way.
3.
There you go. Way to drop quick. That's perfect. Great job. Good
7.
Rhythm. Perfect,
8.
Lexie. Love it. Yeah. Way to work. Way to work. All right. Now, let's move on to shooting. Everybody can grab some water. If you have some water, you want to grab some real quick, you can. We'll take a quick pause. I do have a question for you while we're grabbing some water. You come from a family of basketball players. Your dad played in the NBA, you know, won a dunk contest. Seen your younger brother play in Georgia. He's talented. So there's obviously something that's creating a positive environment for you guys to flourish. What is that? And maybe do you have a message to other parents that could, you know, show them the way to raise successful young basketball players who are healthy with the game?
I think for us, it's just always been a really supportive environment. I started playing basketball pretty early, about 7 or 8 years old. My two other sisters, one decided to play, and one didn't decide to play, one did decide to play. And, you know, we were all supportive of the things that they chose to do. But I think the best thing parents can do and family members can do is just be supportive of whatever your child or brother or sister or niece or nephew decides to pursue. Just be supportive of them, and I think that they'll flourish.
I love that so much. We all love the game, but you have to keep it fun and be supportive in order for that love and that passion to remain. So that's awesome. Thank you for sharing that. We're going to do a couple of just really quick shooting drills. So one thing that's really important in basketball is being able to get the ball from wherever it is you're dribbling or pivoting into your shot pocket so you're ready to shoot. So what we're going to do is just have our left foot as our pivot foot, and Lexie, you're going to be able to pivot kind of in any direction. You can move the ball anywhere you want, but when I say shot, I want you to get into that shot pocket and bend those knees nice and low in a triple threat stance. Exactly. So you might be pivoting around, boom, I say shot, and you drop into it nice and quick. Okay, so we're just going to do 4 reps with that left foot and then 4 reps with the right foot. Okay, getting into the shot pocket quick. All right, on you. Go, good. Shot. Boom, good, great job. There's one, right back to it. Yep, you give it anywhere. Good, shot. There it is, good. Right back to it. Shot. Nice, good. One more that way, one more. Shot. Perfect, great job. Great job. Now we'll do the same thing on the other foot. So we're working on that footwork, pivoting at the same time. Great job. Shot. Perfect, good. There's one. Shot. Great job. There's two. We got two more. Two more. Shot. There it is. Good. Last one here. Last one here. Good footwork. Good balance. Shot. That's great. Good. Way to mix it up. Perfect. Great job. Now, the next one, what we're going to do here is we're going to tap the ball in front. You're going to be in a nice stance. And I'm going to call out either left, right, right, left, or hop. And so you know this, as a shooter, sometimes you have to be able to step in with your left foot first and then right and go up and shoot. Sometimes it's got to be right, left, and sometimes it's a hop. So that's the footwork I want you to do, and you're actually going to jump. So you're here, and I say left, right, we go left, right, and we jump to shoot, okay? So we come back to the spot, boom, right, left, and up, okay? And you get five good reps, five good reps, okay? So nice and low, tapping quick, good. Right, left. Right, left, and up. Perfect. Good job. Right back to the spot. There's one. Good. Left, right. There it is. And up. Perfect. Good footwork. Good balance. Great job. Hop. Perfect. Perfect. Two more. Two more. Two more. Hop. Great job. Great job. Last one. Right, left. Great job. Perfect. All right. Perfect. You're great on balance, moving both directions perfectly, and that's what we have to establish with the young people out there. So great job. Great job. All right. We're going to do one quick defensive drill, and then I'm going to ask you a defensive question because you were Defensive Player of the Year in college in the ACC, which is big time. So the drill, what we're going to do here is we're just going to both be active with wide base, good stance, arms are out, and we're going to have quick feet going, okay? When you're moving those quick feet, I'm going to say left or right. If I say left, we turn our hips to the left and back to center and keep going. Right is turn to the right and keep going, okay? So nice and quick, high intensity. Got it?
This reminds me of college.
Exactly. Exactly, okay? We're going to go for about 10 seconds here, all right? Here we go. Quick, quick, quick. Here we go. Left. Good. Right. 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 Good. Keep working, keep working, keep working. Left. Good. 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 Left. Good job. Relax.
Woo!
Feel the burn. Feel the
right,
burn. I love it. I love it. Great job, Lexie. So one last question for you before you go. Being such a great defender, we all think about being in a stance and moving our feet. What can you tell us about, what can we do to be a better defender with our arms? Obviously, our hands and our arms play a big part of our defensive game. So what can we do there? What can we think about when we're playing defense to be better with our hands?
You just got to think about deflections. And I know sometimes people just get caught up in stops and steals, but one of the most important stats in a game is one that you can't count, and that's deflections. So if your arms are up, you know, you're disrupting people's passes, you're getting on people's nerves, and you just look like an active, athletic defender. And then most importantly, your effort. Defense is all about effort. So at the end of the day, that's something that you can always control in a game, is how hard you go on the defensive end.
I love it. That's so true. Great knowledge. Thank you for the nuggets. And we have to finish with a compliment session. Thank you, Lexie, for your time and for giving back to the junior NBA, the youth of the world, to participate with you here.
Of course. Thank you for having me, and positive vibes only.
Positive vibes only.